Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Fallout 4 Mods Weekly, Episode 10.
Welcome home.
You asked for it, and you shall receive. Now, during my absence in covering mods for Fallout 4, we've seen a massive influx in the amount of mods released for this game, and I'm actually very upset that I've missed out on so many of them. A lot of the mods for Fallout 4 have been giving the game a tactical military overhaul, and I honestly love these sort of mods. So to start off, let's take a look at Ballistic Skull Mask by HeroicPie. And while it only adds one ballistic mask, which you can craft at the chem bench, it allows you to modify it with a load of different retextures at the armor workbench. If you include the default skin itself, there are a total of 32 options to choose from here, which is honestly just wild. So let's start off with the default skin. This is the ballistic mask itself, completely untouched with a retexture. And as you may notice, Duracell will not stop anything from hitting your eyes. But of course, there is an available optional file to add glass over your eyes. I personally opted for the non-eye coverage. So as for the 31 additional options, here's what the mod offers. Atric Camo, Atric Hex, Black, Blue Steel, Bronze, Chrome, Copper. I need to search up how to say that word because I didn't want to f*** it up and get bullied. Cyan, Desert Camo, Desert Hex, Emerald, Ghost 1, Ghost 2, Ghost 3, Ghost 4, Ghost 5, Gold, Gray, Oil Chrome, Rainbow, Red, Red Urban Camo, Red Urban Hex, Rose Gold, Snow Camo, Snow Hex, Urban Camo, Urban Hex, White, Woodland Camo, and Woodland Hex. And those are all the 32 options you get to choose from with this mod. I think that's plenty enough. Overall, you cannot go wrong with this mod because it will add to that tactical military feel that so many other mods are adding to this game. Next up is a little bit more of a futuristic take on a military tactical helmet. And this is Eva Recon by Wolf AOT, adding not just a new helmet, but also a scarf to go along with it, which can be obtained at the chem station. And while this mod does not offer 32 options, I would not expect it to. So with that said, you have the default option and then a Legionnaire option, which at first glance, you might not notice a significant difference here, but the Legionnaire option has a few small details etched out on the helmet itself. And I actually really like that he took the routes of just slightly changing the skin to fit the Legionnaire kind of style and not going all out on changing the entire look of the helmet itself. I also love the additional touch of adding a scarf to go along with it, as I don't know what it is with these kinds of scarves, but it just definitely fits in with the whole military thing for me. Just is ingrained in my brain as being that nice little sprinkle on top, but it's just a sweet and tiny addition to the mod that just rounds it out with certain outfits. Now, next up is another mod adding to this military tactical overhaul of Fallout 4, and that being Railroad Heavy Overhaul by Ghost FC3S, a mod that overhauls a faction that honestly truly needs it. I mean, come on, like the mod author says, whatever that thing was that the Railroad Heavies are wearing, the scavenged trench coats with armor duct taped into it, was due for a serious upgrade. Not only does this armor look like it actually fits in to Fallout 4, but the coolest part has to be the implementation of it and the sort of backstory that the mod author gave it. Because the backstory here is that the armor was repurposed from fallen foes and put to good use. So this mod replaces the heavies with scavenged and salvaged armor from the gunners, that being the overhauled tactical military equipment Gallic Redux mod, the Brotherhood of Steel, Brotherhood of Steel armor overhaul, and synths through the tactical courser mod. So it's taking pieces from each and every one of those mods and giving it a scavenged and salvaged look to then turn it into its own railroad armor, which is such a cool implementation. Just makes me appreciate this mod so much more. Now, going to a little bit more of a wild side, we have NASA Emu Suit by MyCart, a mod for anyone that wanted to go to space as a child, but then came to the realization that they weren't quite up to the task. Well, now you can get a NASA spacesuit made for extravehicular use in space. There's only one problem though, you're also not going to be going to space in Fallout 4, so you're still not quite making it. So if you're truly wanting the full space experience, you're going to have to wait for Starfield, but if you want to make it halfway there, you've always got this super high quality NASA Emu suit. And the amount of detail in this mesh and texture is just a sight to see. However, if you use something like body physics, you're gonna have issues with this, guaranteed. Because let's just say, I don't know how the breasticles made it all the way up into the helmet, but I thought it was something I should point out. Overall, it's a really great mod, but if you have any mods that conflict with it, it's something you're not gonna wanna use unless you can go ahead and figure out how to fix it yourself. But I wanted to show this mod anyway because it is super high quality. And if anyone wants to pretend they're gonna go on space travel but never actually make it to space, you can now do that. I mean, you could also play Fallout 76, but I've heard that a lot of people don't want to do that. So Fallout 4 is now an option as well. Moving on to what might be the most pointless texture overhaul. It's very high quality, don't get me wrong, but say hello to authentic handmade weaponry, Pipe Gun Retexture by SpiffySkyTrooper. This is a high quality texture overhaul for the pipe weaponry in Fallout 4, and that is the reason why I say it's probably the most pointless. Because let's be real, who actually uses these weapons? They're absolute garbage. I don't think you should touch them, but if you are someone that every once in a while picks these up and don't want to be absolutely jarred that they don't fit in with all your other retextures, this mod is available for you, and it does the job perfectly. And yes, for those that are worried, it retextures each and every handmade texture, except for the copper barrels, because he says those look fine. So although I have probably an unnecessary level of hatred towards the pipe weapons in Fallout 4, this is still a wonderful mod. It's still a mod you should check out, still a mod you should download, especially if you're a complete psychopath and you actually use these weapons. Now, for those of you that are absolutely insane enough to use weapons as bad as the pipe weapons or handmade weapons in Fallout 4, I have a perfect mod for you because you're gonna need some extra time to kill the FeralGhouls. So this is where FeralGhouls Slower Vanilla Attack Animations by Vivek comes in, which modifies the different vanilla animation files for the FeralGhouls so that they not only run, but also attack twice slower. The only reason why I even bring up this mod is because this is probably one of my biggest annoyances with Fallout 4, having every FeralGhoul in the wasteland be like Barry f***ing Allen. These goddamn ghouls come out of the woodworks, and then all of a sudden, they're just inside of you. Now we're just turning them into slow blobs of flesh. I will say, this mod also came in handy when it came to covering the next mod, and that being A Life Torn Apart by FalloutGuy1995. A mod that adds three small quests, a new lever action gun, a new player home, and a bunch of cool loot for you to come across. And the first emotional quest is based on the mod author's personal long-distance relationship. You'll understand that a little bit more when you play it for yourself. It's a little bit sad. You can see some darkness in there. And the other two seem to just be silly loot and shoot quests, which took me about 50 minutes to an hour to complete, which is a good amount of content. And also keep in mind, I was on a completely cheating save. So there's also that to take into account. It probably would have taken me like an hour and a half, if not longer, if I wasn't cheating my ass off. The player home is an interior settlement, which comes fully decorated and has a backstory. There's a bunch of stuff for you to read, a bunch of cool creatures for you to kill, and who can complain with being left with a beach house? Overall, if you're looking for some short quests to play through, just in a quick sit down, on a modded save, this is definitely a good option, and it leaves you with a nice beach house afterwards, which is located next to East City Downs. And the player home itself is actually really cool and unique in the way that it is built with the workshop elements in Fallout 4, and yet it's still treated as its own interior cell as well. There are some issues that come up with this, and that is that you can scrap the interiors and see into the void. So I'm not sure if that can be solved by the mod author themselves, or if it's just something you have to deal with when you create a building like this. But I think the look of this settlement with this style just totally makes sense for Fallout 4. And if you actually took the time to add upon this settlement, I think you could make it look absolutely amazing. Oh, and by the way, the loot that you get during this is actually well worth it. Gives you a bunch of chems, bottle caps, weapons, ammo, as well as a few cheating items, I guess you could say, that consisting of things like a bobblehead and magazines. It's a nice little addition that makes you feel rewarded for the time that you put into these quests. And for those of you that want to wind down after spending that hour and a half having your life torn apart alongside Fallout Guy 1995, you can throw a few back with Alcohol Effects by Ceftadzime. And this is for those of you that think that drinking alcohol is a little lackluster in Fallout 4. And this mod went further than I thought it did. This is one of those mods that I genuinely didn't even look at the overview for before actually using it. And I thought it just simply added physical effects to the player. And while it does do that with the first drink, the second drink, and the third drink, adding more blur and adding more shaking to your screen, making it harder to actually play the game. The fourth drink is where things get interesting and you black out. You will then regain consciousness at one of 29 locations around the Commonwealth. And I genuinely didn't realize this was a part of the mod, so here's my genuine reaction to that while I was recording.
I didn't know this was a part of the mod.
Blacked out and woke up at a random place. I woke up on a grave, bro.
I genuinely thought it just changed your visual effects.
That's actually pretty cool.
So as you can see, some of the locations it will throw you into are just out in the woods and doesn't put you in any danger. However, some put you in immediate danger, so it's really up to you of whether or not you want to go through with this.
What the f- No f***ing way. No f***ing way, dude. No. No, this is f***ed. Right next to a deathclaw. Bro. Okay, this mod. This mod is mainly just cool because you never know where you're gonna end up.
This honestly adds so much to Fallout 4, so much more than I thought it would, because if you're feeling a little bit bored in Fallout 4 and you just want something to do, toss back four drinks. I know this actually kind of sounds bad now that I'm thinking about it, but toss back four drinks and you'll be thrown somewhere random in the wasteland, and then you can just play it off there. I was honestly not expecting to be thrown in a cage right next to a deathclaw. I quite literally shit myself. It's a fun little mechanic, and I just had to share it with you guys because I wasn't really sure if I was going to share it when I was recording it, as I thought it just added visual effects and I didn't know if that was enough to actually cover this mod, and then I was thrown about randomly into the wasteland, and that made this mod a must to cover here in Mods Weekly. But anyways, guys, that is it for this episode of Fallout 4 Mods Weekly. I hope you all enjoyed, and again, it's going to be every single Friday. I cannot wait to see you guys in the next episode. That's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys want to see more, please smack that like button down below. Subscribe, join the good fight if you haven't already, and ring that bell icon to stay updated in all of my future videos. It'd be super greatly appreciated as always. And until next time, this is Apoqsi, signing off.
I'm actually shitting myself.
What the f- Jesus ticks.
Jesus ticks, eh? That's a new one.
Yay!